All right, Carl. Stage two of Breck Epic. Let's hear the stats from today.
Well, the stage was about 42 miles, a shitload of climbing. On the stickers, it's 65, but I think the Garmin says 52, 4, something like that. But another challenging day, and today it was not just challenging because of the course, but because of other obstacles I have to deal with. A mechanical that just kept on going. In one of the descents, I busted a rear tire over some sharp rocks. So I stopped, see if the sealant would seal it. It did not, so I plugged it. That didn't work because the hole and the damage was much bigger. So I put in a tube, but because I used the DynaPlug, which has a metal tip that stays inside of the tire, which I totally didn't even think about it, because I put a new tube after riding a few miles. The tube busted again because of the metal tip, I'm guessing. I used another tube and then it didn't work. And then I used the third tube. So people were amazing. Everybody who were going by, like, hey, do you need anything? Do you need anything? And, you know, at first I was just kind of like being mean, like, no, I'm okay. And then it's like, what the hell I'm doing? I'm not okay. I don't have anything else left because I use my spare stuff. So then I just started asking, yeah, I just need CO2. Do you have another tube? And so I got, you know, like five, six different CO2s, tubes, and, you know, eventually made it to the finish line. So that's kind of that sum up of the stage. But like I said, it's beautiful here. It's awesome challenge. And some of those days just bring some additional challenge because I guess the course is not hard enough.
No. How was it technically today? Did anything make you nervous or scared or
It's not scared,
test
it's
you?
just kind of like the terrain here and the type of the trails are just different. So it's a lot of loose rocks and like everything's just moving underneath the wheels, just like I said yesterday. And it was that after the first big climb, so we started climbing from the gun, and I was kind of struggling with my back for the whole day today. And as I was descending down after the first climb, I just kind of like it engraved in my memory. Like when you ask, what's your favorite part of the day? What's your worst part of the day? I was like, okay, this is the worst part of the day because that descent was just absolutely gnarly. And like I tried to be careful and be light on the pedals and not bust the tires, of course, you know, and all that. And so I was like, yeah, that was the first part. But then after that was my favorite part because we were on the Colorado Trail and it was just kind of like a going just kind of like a flat edge, just up and down and beautiful. But sometimes the trail would be, it's kind of like you are on the side of the mountain. The trail, it's narrow. And then you just kind of like, you look down, it goes, you know, nobody would ever find you. Or sometimes it would be even like this and you are on the top. It was amazing. So that was my favorite part for sure. And then right before, it was just a tiny little descent before the second major climb of the day. Oops, that's another oopsie that I have to deal with. Another, like the second and the biggest climb of the day, when I'm just about to start climbing, that's where I busted a tire in one of those rocks. So it just kind of, from there, it was just try to make it. Sometimes I would be riding on completely flat tire. Sometimes I would be running next to the bike and just kind of getting stuff from people.
And how did you fuel today?
So again, I had a Morten in the hydration pack, and then I guess I have few chews. And then when I came to the second aid station, which you were volunteering, you filled up my pack with Guroctane drink. I ate something, a bar, I think, and has a few chews. And then I just at that point I
Had
was
some
pretty,
coke.
oh yeah, Coke. Yeah, at that point I was pretty exhausted from, like, after each attempt to fix my tire, then just kind of chasing and passing people, and just kind of like it was a lot of effort spent that I probably shouldn't spend. So I was pretty tired for the last 10, 12 miles, whatever it was. And it was still two big climbs, which didn't look like much on the profile, but they were significant. And another obstacle that is just kind of occurring on during the mountain bike now is, since I have a plate, and hardware in my wrist. It's just, I guess, it pressing on the nerve. So over the time, as I'm trying to hold and break, you know, the hand just kind of cramps up, the fingers get into weird shape, and it hurts, and I cannot control it. I have to just kind of manually pull it down. So that was challenging as well. But yeah, eventually made it to the finish, and now I'm just kind of trying to wrap my head around it. Tomorrow it's another day. I have to do it all over again.
And tomorrow's a big day.
Yeah. So.
And how do you feel overall? How's your fatigue level?
So at the beginning of today's stage, I was surprised how actually I felt pretty good. And, you know, until the point where I had a flat tire, I actually felt like I'm managing my resources. I'm not doing anything silly, but I'm actually more ahead up to the front there than what I expected. And so I was happy about that. But then it changed, and right now I'm really, really exhausted, and muscles hurt, my back hurts, everything hurts. So hopefully I can recover some overnight, and get going again tomorrow.